I'm back with the 81 Dodge Colt gas tank saga. So, next up is the sandblasting, the next phase. I remember seeing something about a phase in a previous video, but I can't remember just which phase I said I was on. So we're gonna skip that. Yeah, we're gonna skip that. So this is what we have, the gaping holes. So we have now gotten our product that we're gonna repair this with, and it requires blasting. You are not going to wire wheel this. I know. There are several of you who are going to say, you know, use the POR 15 sealer. Okay, POR 15 is not going to fix this. Okay? Just not going to happen. So we have to do it this way. Now, mind you, having a video camera in close proximity to sandblasting is not a good idea. So I'm going to put it over here, and you'll have to watch from there. But first, a little music from the Lister pump. Maestro? Since everybody always wants to see just the ugly stuff, I'll just show you the ugly stuff, and then when I'm done with ugly stuff, I'll just show you what it's like when it's done. There you go! Ugliness! There you go. Nice, white, clean, pretty metal. So with everything blasted to white metal, not to be confused with white city metals, this is the true edge of the fabric that I got. I'm going to lay that against the top edge and conform it to the area of which I need to apply. With a substantial amount of extra fabric, by the way. This edge is on one plane, all the way around the tank. So that's why I'm putting my true edge against that edge, and then I will trim the rest of the fabric to fit accordingly. Warm up the camera, look what happens. No more condensation on the lens. We put our product on here. That corner will smooth down just fine, maybe. Wherever it wants to pucker. Nip out the little puckery section. Now you could slit right down the top of the crease and then just overlap. I don't particularly want to do that. I would rather do it the upholsterer's way. We're just going to remove that creasy part. Too much. But there's no pits or holes right there, so we'll be fine. That'll smooth out. All that'll smooth out. We get into this pinchy, creasy corner. So going from my previous experience in that we will use our lines merely as a guide and leaving it pinchy, we'll come above those lines and do that. And that should be perfectly perfect. In case you didn't miss it, there's the gaping hole there, so easily enough taken care of. This product that we were about to use has a 25-minute working time at 70 degrees. That is not much time, so if you're going to use this, make sure you do all this before you mix it up. Which reminds me, I need a 70-degree ambient, and I just don't happen to have one, unless I go over to... Tony!
Why? I'm going home. I'm done.
Yeah?
Yep.
What's your grumpy level today? Sounds like about a 6. You qualified to do this? Okay, maybe a 5. What are you going to run a chainsaw on?
I know a little bit.
Yeah? You don't burn wood.
But when somebody else plays with it.
Yeah? You loaned it out?
My caretaker used it.
You have a caretaker?
What?
You have a caretaker?
Yeah. He lives on my property for free and takes care of things.
I know he don't take care of you.
No. Better not. I got enough problems.
You cause enough problems.
I'll leave that up to you. How's that?
You cause enough problems.
Now what?
Where are we going to go?
How do I know? You're the doctor, not me.
Yeah, well, you've taken up the available bench space there.
Well, you're going to work over there.
I guess I'll do it right here. I'll do it in the paint booth.
No, take your work over here. It's a lot warmer over here.
I think the paint booth will work fine.
I've had it.
It's less work to use the paint booth.
I've had it.
All right, step one. Now, oh, look at that. I just did that. That's lovely. This was the fuel sock. I have replacement, which has to go on there. We should just put the dirt inside there. So I gotta take care of that first. New sock installed. Ooh, more toys. Is this the one that sat over here forever, but you couldn't work on because somebody else was in your shop?
It's been laying underneath there.
Yeah.
There's an old Cheus, and I bought it in the Bay Area way back in the 90s. And
just now getting around to it?
Well, I rebuilt the engine, put a sleeve in it, and something happened or blew up. So I bought this on eBay, brand new.
The muffler?
For $450. And I married the two together.
And they lived happily ever after.
Well, not yet. I need someone to help me with this wiring.
That ain't me.
That's one thing I'm not good at.
Okay, maybe a 5.